Alhamdulillah, نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم عباد الله أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله قال الله تعالى ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. Dear brothers and sisters, the topic for today is very important. As important as the chip to the computer, as important as a DOS and as a Windows to the computer. This goes beyond the individual and the family and the community and the nation. It goes beyond the planet Earth to the whole universe, all the way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the subject for today, inshallah, will be about al-adl, justice. Al-qism, al-isaf, fairness. All of us, we know that al-adl is one of the asma'illah al-husna, Allah attributes. The same thing, al-muqsid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa al-muqsid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa al-haq. And these topics we will, inshallah, dwell on it in the coming 20 minutes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has established justice all over, covering everything in this universe and this life and in the hereafter. We know from the Quran, many ayahs tell us about the hereafter and the justice which will measure even habbat khardal, if good, so, and if bad, so little. Dear brothers and sisters, all of you have, or some of you have encyclopedias. You probably call it through a salesman. And that salesman, if he's so good, he would sell you with it 20, 30 volumes of books you will never open and stays in its plastic cover. And those books called Synopticon. And the author or the chief editor of those books called Adler, and he's a philosopher well known in this country. And that philosopher is so much preoccupied with Western civilization. And in that book, he had 102 ideas which run the Western civilization. And he went through all these ideas and he has chosen with difficulty six of those great ideas. And out of those six great ideas, he divided them in two, three and three. And out of the three, the first three, he chose one idea to be the dominant thing, and the second group, another idea to be the dominant thing. And he came up with two ideas which he claimed that this is the backbone of Western civilization and the greatness of what's happening nowadays in the West. And those two ideas is truth and justice. And alhamdulillah, I don't have to go to encyclopedias and synopticon and all those ideas. I have to go to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who tells me, وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا. Truth and justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the universe established on truth and justice. لَا مُبَدِّلَ لِكَلِمَاتِهِ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Dear brothers, we have witnessed in the last 70 years a great empire, which they call the Soviet Union, based on falsehood, on lies, and on injustice towards the minorities, towards Muslims, Shashan, and all of this, we see it in our own eyes. What happened to that empire? It crumbled. And we see the West going very strong. Why? Because he's very keen on establishing truth and justice. Truth in the media, truth in everything they tell to the best of their abilities. And the same thing with justice. No wonder we see all those lawsuits against Texaco and against Wall Street and all of this. Why? Is it for the minorities who are raising those lawsuits? No. It's not to shoot themselves in the foot and have everything crumble. That's why you have thousands and thousands of lawyers in this country, all of them looking for truth and justice. Dear brothers, no wonder Ibn Taymiyyah radiallahu anhu, and he lived before all this West. He said, "Inna Allah yansuru ad-dawla al-'adila wa in kana al-kafira." Allah support the just country or just civilization or state, even if it is kafira. What does this tell us? It tells us that justice is a law, like the physics law. If you have a plane and it crashes, you think the Muslim will be saved and non-Muslim will die? Everyone will die. Why? Because this is physics law, mechanics. Nobody will live. The same thing here. Justice is something that does not follow the hawa and the whim. And inshallah, we'll go through this. The essence of our deen is truth and justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent all those prophets with what? وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ, to establish truth and justice. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many, many ayahs in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching him and ordering him. And he is telling us, وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ, to establish justice. وَإِنْ حَكَمْتَ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطِ, by justice. The seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no page does not touch on truth and justice. Go and read the seerah, dear brothers. And one of those stories I can tell you now, عن أبي سعيد الخدري قال جاء أعرابي إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتقاضاه دينا كان له عليه. A man, Arabi, from the desert, is raw, is illiterate usually. He comes and he asks the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I gave you something one day last year and I want it back. And he was rude. حتى قال له أحرج عليك إلا قضيتني فانتهره أصحابه. And you know who's around the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Umar ibn Khattab was ready to shred him into pieces. Muhammad ibn Maslam, Sa'd ibn Mu'ad. And they made a hum. You don't know who, to whom you're talking. أتدري من تكلم؟ قالوا ويحك. أتدري من تكلم؟ قال إني أطلب حقي. That weak man, stranger, he asking, I want my right. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was angry. Not from the man, he was angry from his companions. And he told them, هَلَّا مَعَ صَاحِبِ الْحَقِّ كُنْتُمْ, you should side with this man, not with me. ثُمَّ أَرْسَلَ إِلَى خَوْلَ بِنْ دُقَيْسِ فَقَالَ لَهَا إِنْ كَانَ عِنْدَكِ تَمْرٌ فَأَخْرِجِينَ حَتَّى يَأْتِينَ تَمْرُنَا فَنَقْضِيكِ فَقَالَتْ نَعَمْ بِأَبِي أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to one of the sahabiyat and he borrowed some dain. And he gave the man, and he gave him more, till he was happy and satisfied. فَقَضَ الْأَعْرَابِ وَأَطْعَمَهُ فَقَالَ أَوْفَيْتَ أَوْفَ اللَّهُ لَكَ. You have fulfilled your promise. And then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uttered those words, which every one of us should write him and hang him in his office or room. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّهُ لَا قُدِّسَتْ أُمَّةٌ. It is any ummah is not blessed. لا يأخذ الضعيف فيها حقه غير متعتع. Any weak person does not have his right. Not with lawyers and with hardship and difficulties and kissing hands and asking for intercession. غير متعتع, it means with that most ease. That's his right and he has to take it and go. And this is the way Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught his students in the school of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which graduated the companions. And go and read Hayat al-Sahaba and you have hundreds of stories about fairness and truth and justice. And let us take two examples. One from Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And all of us, we know Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. What was his inauguration speech? How did he start that speech? It was 5-6 lines. He started the whole thing with truth and justice. He told us, As-Siddiqu amana. You put your trust in me and I'm going to be truthful. وَالْكَذِبُ خِيَانَ أَضْضَعِيفُ فِيكُمْ قَوِي عِنْدِي حَتَّى أَرُدَّ عَلَيْهِ حَقَّهُ. The weak among you is strong till I give him his right. وَالْضَعِيفُ فِيكُمْ وَالْقَوِيُّ فِيكُمْ ضَعِيفُ. And the prestigious, the rich, the powerful is weak in front of me till I take the right from him. InshaAllah. Dear brothers, go to the books and read. Teach your children better than wasting your time in front of TV watching those programs and the intendos. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, which his name synonymous with truth and justice. Al-Farooq, his name. Al-Adil. Also, go to the books and read hundreds of stories about the justice and fairness which even till nowadays they fall far low than to reach that summit. Umar ibn al-Khattab, he has an older brother. His name was Zayd ibn al-Khattab. And he was taller than Umar and greater than Umar, and he became Muslim before than Umar. And he was martyred and killed before Umar. And Umar ibn al-Khattab used to cry him so hard. Every time the wind blow, he would remember Zayd ibn al-Khattab. And Zayd ibn al-Khattab was martyred in Furub al-Ridda, where the Muslim fought those who wanted to separate the zakat from salah. And one of those followers of Musaylim al-Kadhab, and his name, Abu Maryam al-Saluli, min Bani Hanifa, he was the one who killed Zayd ibn al-Khattab. And later on it happened, he became Muslim. And he became a good Muslim. And you know, Islam yajubbu ma qablahu. It erases the past and he started fresh, a new king. And one day, Abu Maryam al-Saluli min Bani Hanifa was in the face of Umar ibn al-Khattab. And there was an encounter and questions to be asked and answered. Go to the books and read it. But what I would tell you here, that Abu Maryam asked Umar ibn al-Khattab, told Abu Maryam, Wallahi inni la uhibbuk, I do not like him. How would he like him and he killed his dear brother? Then Abu Maryam asked him, Qala fatamna'uni lidhalika haqqan, would you be unfair to me? Qala Umar ibn al-Khattab, la. Truth and justice, regardless of your feeling, desires. قَالَ فَلَا ضَيْرٌ. Then I don't care. إِنَّمَا يَأْسَفُ عَلَى الْحُبُّ النِّسَاءِ. Abu Maryam told him, I really don't care about it. If you love me or you hate me, I care about to be treated fairly. And he left. Dear brothers, the examples are so abundant in our books. We need to go and read it. But when and where? If we don't take any action, come to the masjid, do something. We need to read the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and our history. Dear brothers, our deen, if you open the Quran and any page of it, you find the word adil, qasd, hukm, all of these terms. And for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقَسْطِ. Allah ordered us to be just. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering us to be fair, to be just. And above all that, to be loving and caring, and inshallah, in future khutbah we'll talk about this. And that's what make our system a superior one. And we see the havoc and the mess out there, everyone suing everyone, and nobody getting his right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, وَإِذَا قُلْتُمْ فَعْدِلُوا. When you talk, when you determine something, say something, be fair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, when two people are fighting, فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا بِالْعَدْلِ وَأَقْصِطُوا. Be fair. Fix the relation with just and fairness. Even the Christians, the Jews, the non-Muslims, we have, as long as no state of war, we have to be fair and just to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ. To be kind and fair and just to them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. And more than that, your feeling is separate from being fair. Being fair is like 2 + 2 = 4 in any condition you are in. If you are angry, if you are happy, if he's your friend, is it your enemy? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ لِلَّهِ شُهَدَاءَ بِالْقِسْطِ. Fair and just. وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَى أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا. If you hate somebody, that doesn't give you a license to be unfair to him. You have to be fair. اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. We have a lot of line of biases and prejudices from family, person himself, his wife, his family, his race, his country. You go all over the globe and you see how you are treated. You are lucky if you come out with your skin safe. And here we see this ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ. Even against your own self. أَوِ الْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ إِنْ يَكُنْ غَنِيًّا أَوْ فَقِيرًا. If he is powerful, rich or poor. Fairness and justice has nothing to do with all of these. It's irrelevant. This is a law, like the gravity law. Every Muslim has to be fair and just regardless. فَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا الْهَوَىٰ أَنْ تَعْدِلُوا. And here's the disease. Why we exercise unjust, unfairness, which we call it in Arabic, بَذِي. Because there is هَوَىٰ behind it. There is whim, desires, short gain. But this is very destructive. When we exercise بَذِي, it will affect the whole society and community and the whole ummah. And this is what we are witnessing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had warned us in his book and told us, إِنَّمَا بَغْيُكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ. When we exercise injustice, unfairness, it will backlash. Even the ones who started this will be victims eventually. No wonder that Imam Ibn Taymiyyah has told us, العدل واجب لكل أحد على كل أحد في جميع الأحوال. Fairness and justice is a must in all conditions. It has nothing to do with the other party. Dear brothers and sisters, I encourage myself and you to be fair and just towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created us and blessed us with everything. And he wants from us to worship him, to pray to him, and do the lawful and avoid the unlawful. Very simple. 1, 2, 3. Be fair with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to be fair and just with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who has delivered the amana wa ballagha ar-risala. And we have to carry this message. And I'm not asking you to carry it to China or to Russia or to the West and East. Carry it to your own children, for God's sake. Teach your children Islam. Teach them salah, teach them zakah. Be fair and just. Let not that chain of 1,400 years of Islam stop at you, and your children become in the best condition nothing, and the worst condition to become enemies of Islam and Christian Jews. And we have many examples in this society. And they start with choosing the right wife for your child. The Muslim, the righteous girl. Dear brother, be righteous with your own self, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala خلقك في أحسن تقويم and made you khalifa. do not go and follow your desires and go and be low like what we see in the societies with all the sins and fawahish going on. Lift yourself, be with the righteous, مع الأنبياء والصديقين والشهداء وحسن أولئك رفيقا. Dear brothers, be fair and just with your wife. Your wife. Don't hell broke loose if she is not fix you food or did this or that. Your wife, fix your home, bring your children, risk herself and her life when she deliver a baby and this and that. Be fair with her. She is satisfying your desire, your sexual desires and all of this. When she had a little shortcoming, don't explode. Don't abuse. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, nobody would abuse his wife at the beginning of the day and the end of the day, go and sleep with her. In another hadith, لا يفرق مؤمن مؤمنا. A husband should not hate his wife. إن كره منها خلقا رضي منها آخر. She is not perfect. If she has something bad, she has something good. And accept with 50-50. This is the insaf. This is the adil. This is the justice. Dear brothers, with your children be fair. You brought him this life, not to ignore him or leave him or abandon them. Attend them. Give him a lot of love and warmth and compassion, and teach him salah, and teach him healthy sports and all of that. Raise him up Islamically. Be fair, dear brother, with your family, with your relatives. They have a right over you. Silatul Rahim. Go and visit them and check on them and help them if you can. And dear sister, you be fair and just. You are not created to work out there. You are not created to do secretarian jobs or do cleaning or this and that unless you are in dire need to make honest, decent living. If you have no brothers or father or whatever, I know conditions are difficult, but I want you to be fair. Your place is to nurse your children with the milk, to nurse them, makarim al-akhlaq, the moral values. This is your job. Unfortunately, most of our sisters sit in home, but they are ignorant. They don't know how to raise kids. No wonder our kids, you go any public place, you find them like monkeys jumping all over. And you see the Christian kids and Jews kids, they are very disciplined. This is a phenomenon that talked to me about it, hundreds of brothers. Why? At home, if you do not know, read Islam, how tarbiyat al-awlad, how you raise your children, how do you, there's many books, many educate, many courses, many everything. You have to be prepared and weapon, have a weapon to teach your kids moral values like honesty and courage and fairness and justice. Dear brothers, every one of us has to exercise fairness and justice to his fellow human being, especially Muslims in the community, in the masjid, in the, out there. And do to them what you like them to do to you. This is a golden rule. If you want to spit at one, you ask yourself, do I like somebody to spit at me? No, then don't do it. Do to others. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, told us, وَأَنْ يُؤْتَى أَنْ تَأْتِي النَّاسَ بِمَا تُحِبِّ أَنْ يُؤْتَى إِلَيْكَ, to do to them what you like them to do to you. In another hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, that you are not a Muslim or mu'min or true believer. لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبَّ لِأَخِيهِ مَا يُحِبُّ لِنَفْسِهِ. He loves of goodness, of khair to happen to his fellow Muslim before he wish or hope and pray this to happen to him. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين. أستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. جواد كريم برحمته وهو أرحم الراحمين. إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون. Dear brothers, be fair and just to your masjid. This masjid did not come from nowhere. It's of Allah's grace and blessing through the hearts and the hard work and the dedication and the sacrifice of hundreds and hundreds of brothers. And now we are in the process of expanding and renewing and renovating and becoming bigger masjid. Don't take things for granted. This masjid needs help, and be fair and just to this masjid, which you are gaining from it by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establishing salah and all these activities. So be fair. We know Jews and Christians every year with masjid building something or not, they give 10% of their income to their establishment, to their worship place. We're asking far less than that to come up and donate something for the cause of this masjid. Every Muslim should be fair and just and donate something reasonable. If we are here 1,000 people and at least every Muslim should pay $1,000, at least. And 4,000 the average. Otherwise, who's gonna build it? And we are short over $1 million. Dear brothers, we are very close to our target. May Allah bless you all. Ma'ashara al-Muslimin, اعلموا أن الله قد أمركم بالصلاة على نبيكم في قرآنكم فقال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم اجعلنا هادين مهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وقلوب المسلمين أجمعين واهدنا سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات إلى النور برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.